स्टोरेज क्लास, व्हाट इज स्टोरेज क्लासेस इन सी? इन सी लैंग्वेजेज एवरी वेरिएबल इज हैविंग सम कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स सच एज डेटा टाइप, स्कोप, लाइफ टाइम एंड इट्स डिफॉल्ट वैल्यू. सो स्टोरेज क्लास इज रिलेटेड टू वेरिएबल्स यूज इन सी प्रोग्राम्स. सो स्टोरेज क्लास डिस्क्राइब्स स्कोप एंड लाइफ टाइम ऑफ ए वेरिएबल. सो देयर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ स्टोरेज क्लासेस यूज इन सी. फर्स्ट वन इज ऑटो, सेकेंड वन इज रजिस्टर, थर्ड वन इज स्टैटिक एंड फोर्थ वन इज एक्सटर्नल. सो वन बाई वन वी विल डिस्कस ऑल द फोर टाइप्स ऑफ स्टोरेज क्लासेस यूज इन सी. सो फर्स्ट स्टोरेज क्लास इज ऑटो. तो सिंटेक्स ऑफ ऑटो इज, दिस इज द सिंटेक्स ऑफ ऑटो. It is declared in such a way that auto is a keyword. After that data type is int, float, char, double. These are data types. After that variable name. So we can declare a variable in such a way that auto int x or auto float y or long, or in such a way long auto long x or in auto float y. This is the first. There are two keywords used in auto. Variable declares auto, after that data type, after that variable name. So these are the some important points regarding the auto variable. First point is, if auto variable is not initialized, the auto variable, then in that case it will contain garbage value. Means it will contain meaningless value, means garbage value. Garbage value is the value which is not useful. So if auto variable is not initialized, if we will not initialize the auto variable, it contains by default, it automatically contains garbage value. Second point is, by default all local variables are auto variables. So generally we have declared local variables such as suppose int y. So local variable, this is local variable. Suppose this is a body inside this variable is declared. So in this situation, this is the local variable. Y is a local variable. So our local variable is by default auto variable. So by default all the local variables are auto variables. For next point is, for every function call, auto variable is recreated and reinitialized. So whenever we call function, it will be recreate and reinitialize. If we call second time, it will again recreate and reinitialize. This point will be clear up with the help of examples. Examples is given below. Next point is, the scope and lifetime of auto variable is within the body. So what is scope? Scope is the region in which the variable is accessible and available is called scope of the variable. And lifetime is, we know that value exists. Suppose if you declare a variable x, if assign x is equal to 10, so this value 10 will be, this value 10 will be in, exist only within the body of the program in which this x variable is declared. So for the two terms is here, scope and lifetime. Scope is the region in which variable is accessible and available is called scope of the variable. And next is lifetime. Lifetime is in which the variable contains the value. If you initialize a value x with 10, then in this case the x will contain 10 only within that body in which it is declared. So these are all important points regarding the auto variables. These all points will be clear after discussing example. Here we have given an example. In example we have given a main function. In main function we have called a user defined function test 3 times. Yes. And test is, definition of test function is written here. In test function, there are three statements used in test function. So first time, we know that the execution of program starts with main. Here in main, first statement is test. We are calling function test. So when we call function test, it will control goes to here. While we call the function test, in test first statement is auto int x, means we declaring a auto variable. Suppose this is our auto variable having name x, and it will assign a value 50. 50 will be assigned to this variable x, and this variable x will have some memory location. Suppose it will allocated at memory location 500. Memory location is just assumption, value may vary from system to system. It is just assumption that it will be allocated at 500 location. So this statement is executed. We declare a auto variable x and assign a value x. Value x is equal to 50. So this next statement print a percentage ds. So here output of this program will be, it will print just the value of x. The value of x is 50. So output will be, first time it will print 50. After that, next statement, two statements, okay. After that, next statement is x is equal to x plus 10. So we incrementing the value of x by 10. So this 50 will be overwritten by, it will 60. After that, control is returned back to here. So first time function calling complete. In next statement, we again call function test. So next time we calling function test, so again control goes here. We are declaring the variable x, auto int x. So we have to recall that point. For every function call, auto variable is recreated and reinitialized. Means creation of variable x is fresh creation. So x will be created due to this statement auto int x. Suppose this is some memory location, suppose 600. It will 600 is the memory location, and auto int x contains 50. So 50 will be assigned to x, because auto variable is in every function call, auto variable is recreated and reinitialized. For every function call, auto variable is recreated and reinitialized. So we are calling test function second time. So in that case, it will be recreated and reinitialized. So it will contain 50. So next statement is print a percentage. This is okay. Print a percentage x. So output will be here 50. 50 will be again 50 will be printed. Second time 50 will be printed. After that, x is equal to x plus 10, means value of x will be incremented by 10. So 60 will overwritten and 50 will overwritten and it will contain 60. After completion of function text, control goes back to here. In next statement, we calling again function text. So control again goes here. Our first statement is auto int x. So in auto variable, for every function call, auto variable is recreated. So recreation will be done here. This variable is recreated once again. X, it has some memory location. Assume that it will be allocated at memory location 700. So for every function call, auto variable is recreated and reinitialized. So fresh initialization of X will be done. So X will contain 50. 50 will be assigned here. In next statement, print a percentage x. So that value of x will be printed. The value of x will be x is 50. So 50 is printed here. In next statement, x is equal to x plus 10. So value of 50 is becomes 60. And after completion of function test, control goes to here, and there is no any statement, so execution of main is completed. So here in main function, we call user defined function test 3 times. In every call, there is auto int x. Due to auto int x, in every function call, x is created and initialized again. So for every function call, auto variable recreated here, auto x is recreated again and again. We call function test 3 times, and so 3 times x is created, and 3 times we have initialized it with x. So for every function call, auto variable recreated and reinitialized. After that, all the other execution is done. So in all the three cases output will be 50 50 50. So this effect is x is to x plus 10 is not reflected back to in next function call. So first discussion of auto variable is over. Next type of storage class is register. Syntax of register variable declaration is keyword register, after that data type variable name. So variable will be declared in such a way that register, suppose we want to declare int data type, so register int x. If you want to declare float variable, register float x. So in this way we can declare the register variable. So these are the some of the important points regarding the register storage class. The keyword register is not a command. So keyword register is not a command, it is just request to the compiler to allocate. Keyword register is not command, it gives just request, it just requests the compiler to allocate memory in register instead of RAM. We declare a variable, and if we declare any variable, default it will be allocated in RAM, means our main memory. But if we use register keyword, so in that case we just request for compiler to allocate the memory in register variable instead of RAM. Next point is if free register, our request will be completed or not completed, it depends on the availability of the register. If the free registers are available, then memory will be allocated in the registers. Otherwise, it will be allocated in the main memory. We already know that register is a very small memory, and so it has a very limited memory, so our request may or may not be fulfilled. So if free registers are available, then allocation will be done in registers. If not, allocation is done in the main memory. By default, all the register variable behaves like auto variable. You have already discussed auto variables and its type, auto variables and its property. So रजिस्टर वेरिएबल इज बाय डिफॉल्ट ऑटो वेरिएबल. सो रजिस्टर वेरिएबल इज नो सॉरी रजिस्टर वेरिएबल बिहेव्स लाइक ऑटो वेरिएबल. सो बाय डिफॉल्ट रजिस्टर वेरिएबल बिहेव्स लाइक ऑटो वेरिएबल. रजिस्टर वेरिएबल्स आर वेरी फास्ट बिकॉज रजिस्टर इज वेरी फास्ट मेमोरी. सो एक्सेस मेमोरी इज वेरी फास्ट इन केस ऑफ रजिस्टर. सो रजिस्टर वेरिएबल आर वेरी फास्ट वाइल एक्सेसिंग कंपेयर टू ऑटो वेरिएबल. इट इज यूज इन लूप्स एंड फॉर्मल पैरामीटर्स. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस व्हाट इज फॉर्मल पैरामीटर्स इन फंक्शन एंड लूप्स इन लूप चैप्टर. सो इट इज रजिस्टर वेरिएबल्स इज यूज जनरली यूज इन लूप्स एंड फॉर्मल पैरामीटर्स. दैट इज फॉर्मल पैरामीटर्स इज इन फंक्शन. सो रजिस्टर इज नथिंग न्यू. इट इज जस्ट रिक्वेस्ट फॉर कंपाइलर टू एलोकेट द मेमोरी इन रजिस्टर इंस्टेड ऑफ रैम. और रिक्वेस्ट विल बी फुलफिल व्हेन रजिस्टर वेरिएबल इज फ्री. इफ रजिस्टर वेरिएबल सॉरी रजिस्टर मेमोरी इज फ्री. इफ रजिस्टर इज नॉट फ्री देन आवर एलोकेशन इज डन इन द मेन मेमोरी. सो इट इज फुल्ली डिपेंडेंट ऑन द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द रजिस्टर्स. नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ स्टोरेज क्लास इज स्टैटिक. इन स्टैटिक स्टोरेज क्लास कीवर्ड स्टैटिक इज यूज आफ्टर डेटा टाइप वेरिएबल. स्टैटिक इंट एक्स इज द डिक्लेयर्स ऑफ स्टैटिक वेरिएबल हैविंग नेम एंड इट्स डेटा टाइप एक्स. यू कैन यूज स्टैटिक फ्लोट वाई या स्टैटिक. यू कैन डिक्लेयर फ्लोटिंग पॉइंट सच एज स्टैटिक. स्टैटिक विल बी कीवर्ड. Statics float. Float is our float and y. In this way we can declare floating type variable with static keyword. So it's okay. So these are the some of the important points related to statics. Why we have to we have to take care while handling with statics variable. First of all, the variable, static variable, this is first point here. The variable persisting the previous state value, even though the destruction of several function call is called as static variable. So in a static variable, value of the static variable persist even after destruction of our function call. If a static variable is not initialized default, it contains zero. But in case of auto variable, if it not initialized, it contains zero. Sorry, it contains garbage value. So auto variable by default contains zero. Sorry, auto variable by default contains garbage value, but a static variable by default contains zero. A static variable will be created only once. Here this point is noted. A static variable will be created only once and memory will be allocated only once at compile time. And last point is it has local scope and lifetime will be ended after the completion of the program. These all the four points will be cleared after discussing an example. So this is the example. We have defined a function main. In main we have called test function three times and test function is defined here. This is the definition of test function. Here we have each static int x. So first time we calling function test. During first time calling function test, control is transfer back here. In main we have calling test three times. So control is transfer back here. Test first statement is static int x. So static int x, so this will be declared in this way. One minute. suppose this is the name of the variable, and type data type is int and static type. Suppose memory location is 600. Memory location is can be anything, not issue, but value here, value is 50. So here x contain 50. Output will be here, x will be initialized with 50. In next statement, print a percent x. So we have to print the value of x. So output will be, what will be output? Output will be 50. So here 50 will be printed. In next statement, what is done? X is equal to x plus 10. So value of 50 will be incremented by 10. So it will be written and it will be 60. So it will contain 60. After all the statements of test function is finished, so control is returned back to calling function text main and call function it is. So in next time we call function text again. We are calling test function again, so again control is transferred back here before discussing this statements. We have to recall that points. The variable, first point is the variable persisting. What is our first point? The variable persisting the previous state value, even though the destruction of several function calls. Here, first time function call is destructed because it is ended, but variable persisting the previous state value. So our variable can persist. The variable is persisting the previous state value 60. And here third point is a static variable will be created only once and memory will be allocated only once at compile time. So while we will call test function next, test we are calling test function again. So a static variable is not fresh creation, it will be used the previous. So here previously it has been created and initialized, and it has current value of x is 60. So this statement is executed only once. It will executed only once at first time. In second call, it will not execute. Only once. So a static int, this statement is executed only once. Second time, it will not executed. Because a static variable will be created only once. And memory will be allocated once at the compile time. So this time it will be not created fresh. It will be used, the value of x is used from previous creation. So this statement is, next statement is print a percent x. So here we have to print the value of x. The value of x is 60. Current value is 60. So output will be 60. So output will be 60. Next statement is x is equal to x plus 10. So we incrementing the value of x by 10. So 60 will be overwritten and it becomes 17. Here we are using a static variable, so value it is not created fresh. Creation is done only once at compile time. After completion of all the statement of function text, control is transfer back here. So here we calling again function text. So control will be transferred to here. Execution of function text begins. First statement is not executed because it is executed only once at compile time. So in next statement, print a percent x. So this statement will print the value of x. Current value of x is 70. So output will be 70. After that, value of x is incremented by 10. So 70 will be overwritten and it will contains 80. So here all the statement of test is executed successfully. After that, control transfer back to main function. Here all the statement of main function is completed, so our program execution is completed. So here in a static case, output we get output 50, 60 and 70, but in case of auto variable we have got output 50, 50, 50, because in auto variable for every function call auto variable is recreated and reinitialized. Here recreated and reinitialized, but in case of a static variable will be created only once and memory will be allocated once at the compile time. So in both cases output will differ. In case of auto variable we get output 50 50 50, but in case of a static variable we get output 50 60 and 70. So this is the difference of how a static variable and auto variables creation execution will occur in our C program. Our next type of storage class is extern. In extern, we use keyword extern data type variable name. So extern int x, in this way we can declare variable. Here two keywords are used, extern and int. After that x, if you want to declare float type, then extern float x. So first point in extern storage, extern variable by default they behave like global variable. We have already discussed in some of the previous classes what are the local variable, what are the global variable. So extern variable by default behave like global variable. Next point is no memory. One thing point is noted, no memory allocated for extern variable and they make use of memory of outside variable. This point will be clear after discussing example. Here no memory will be allocated for extern variable and it will use memory of outside variable. Next point is this variable have a scope and lifetime throughout the program, because extern variable is global variable, so its scope and lifetime is throughout, means over, it exists throughout, means over all program. So this variable, extern variable have a scope and lifetime throughout the program. Fourth point is if it is not initialized default it contains zero. So we have discussed here four types of storage class: auto, register, static and extern. Auto and register by default contains garbage value, while static and extern by default contains zero value. So let's discuss an example for extern variable. This is the program. In program we have declared a global variable A. Here we have declared a global variable A. Suppose we have declared in this way. Int xA means we are naming variable have name A. Suppose it will be allocated to some memory location. Suppose it will be allocated at memory location 1000 is the memory location of A, and value is 50. We are assigning a value 50 to variable A. This is our main program. Sorry, here we have made a mistake. Meant it will be main, not T. It will be overwritten. So main. After these are the statements in main. First statement, extern int A. Here this statement will refer with here. This statement will refer to the extern variable A. Extern variable A is, this is the extern variable. So no memory is allocated. Point is here. Extern variable by default they behave like global variable. Okay. No memory allocated for extern variable and they make use of outside variable. So there is no memory allocation for this A. So for extern variable no memory allocation is done. It uses the it uses what is it they make use of memory of outside. So it make use of memory of outside variable. So here this A will make use of memory of outside variable. This is the outside variable. So this A will make use of outside variable A. So it will only refers this variable. Print percent D age. So here we are printing. So output will be output will be 15. Next statement A is equal to 10. So it will this A is not any this A will not get any memory allocation. So here A is equal to 10 will be overwritten for external variable. So this value will be overwritten with 100. So our variable A will contain 100. Next time we are printing A. So this will print external variable A, and the external value of A is changed from 50 to 100, so output will be 100. So in this way external variable works. These are the sum points with external. So the variable have a scope and lifetime throughout the program, because this variable is external variable. External variable is global variable, and global variable has a scope and lifetime throughout the program. Yeah, there is no memory allocation for external variable. For this variable A, no memory will be allocated. It only refers to the some external variable A. Here some external variable A. So memory for this variable A, memory will be used for this variable. So there is no memory allocation for external variable. It use the outside memory. And here we are changing the value of A. So the value of A will be changed from outside. Outside variable is A here. Value here will be changed from 50 to 100. So here two printf statement will output 50 and 100. So we have discussed four types of storage classes used in C: auto, register, static, extern. Auto and register variable by default contain garbage value, whereas static and extern by default contains zero. Discussion is over. One thing, okay. So today classes, these are the all the discussion about the, so all the four storage classes is finished. So this is the one of the important topics discussed in C.